For six grueling hours, a Senate committee has quizzed the CEOs of Coles and Woolies on the soaring costs of groceries. And like the increasingly expensive steaks found in both their stores, they were in for a grilling.
If the heads of our two biggest supermarkets were expecting a warm welcome from the Senate committee on supermarket prices, that idea was quickly put to bed.
You've thrived in a weak regulatory environment. You've engaged in anti-competitive behaviour.
This is an incredibly competitive market.
That was the crux of the argument from both Woolies CEO, Brad Banducci, and Coles CEO, Leah Weckhart. That other stores like
Costco,
Chemist Warehouse,
independent supermarkets, Aldi, IGA,
and Amazon
mean Australia doesn't live in a duopoly. But there was one question Senator McKim struggled to get an answer to.
You made $1.7 billion in net profit. What was the average size of your equity base in that financial year?
Can you just clarify the question, sorry, Senator?
Well, I'm after your ROE, your return on equity.
And Banducci wasn't keen to answer.
Senator, the numbers we always look at are our return on funds employed.
I'm not interested or asking you about the numbers you look at.
I can only talk to the numbers that we focus on and we measure our business on.
And it kept going like that, with McKim finally losing his patience.
I ask you again, is your return on equity in the last financial year about 26%?
Senator, I've answered the question many times.
You have not answered the question, Mr. Banducci. Honestly, I'm not interested in your spin or your bullshit. This is a Senate inquiry. Answer the question.
Banducci eventually threatened with contempt and even jail time.
A penalty of up to 6 months imprisonment or a fine of not exceeding $5,000.
Coles CEO Leah Weckhart wasn't about to go through all that.
But I am happy to share with you that our return on equity last year was 31%.
The committee quizzed Weckhart on how cost of living pressures are hitting customers and suppliers, but not the supermarkets. But despite Coles achieving a net profit of
just over $1 billion,
it turns out things aren't so rosy for them either.
The financial year 2023, we actually saw a decline in our net profit margin.
So have we got it all wrong? Are supermarkets doing it just as tough as their customers?
Joining us now is the Australia Institute's Greg Jericho, who promises to provide more satisfying answers than what we heard today in Senate estimates. Greg, are you up to that task at the very least?
No, I can neither refuse nor deny the ability to answer any questions to Waleed tonight. I don't think I'm able to.
Bingo. Well done. Congratulations, Greg. Let's start on that last point that we heard in the package. Are the supermarkets the real victims here?
Look, I don't think we need to rush out and start organising a telethon for the supermarkets. They are decidedly not the victims in this at all. They hold a massive market share. And in fact, our research suggests that over the past year, due to their increased profit margins in the food sector, they've probably made an extra $1 billion between them. So certainly not the victims, doing very well. And actually, I think, as we saw today, pretty aggrieved to actually even have to answer questions about why they're doing so well.
Why was that? Like, why do you think Brad Banducci was so reluctant to answer what was a pretty straightforward question? By the way, if you don't feel like answering, we do not have the power to jail you.
I mean... It really was incredible. I mean, I've been watching Senate committee hearings for many years now, and yeah, that's as sad as it does sound. And really, that was the closest I've ever seen anyone get to being held in contempt. It was quite amazing, and it was really just a case of him not wanting to answer it, and then have to deal with all the questions about, well, why are you doing so well? And then being able to say, oh, no, we've got a really competitive industry and we're doing it tough. So,
but nobody's tough on the supermarkets, Greg. And so it seems like that even these inquiries and what are they up to?
Six inquiries going
at the moment. And it kind of feels like showboating. It doesn't seem like there's any genuine appetite for our politicians to actually do anything other than hold another inquiry.
Yeah, I mean, you're right, Kate. There are a lot of inquiries at the moment, and we have had a number of them over the years. It's interesting, this one, though, and I think it's purely because of what we've had over the past 2 years. You know, when you're holding an inquiry into the supermarkets and inflation's pretty benign and it's not too much of an issue, the political pressure is really not there, but it's pretty white hot at the moment. So I think we will see something. Otherwise, you're right. We're just going to be back here in 5-6 years' time having another wonderful inquiry, and Woolworths and Coal CEOs are probably treating the Senate with just as much contempt.
Oh, Greg, we'll see you in 5 years.
No worries, Wally. See you then.